Welcome to Last Word, brought to you by Montgomery Bank. I'm David Jenkins, joined once again by Chris Pasty Legs Pobst here, and we are just back from district baseball. He went to district soccer. I don't know what the deal is with that, but a lot of kicking and a lot of scoring from Notre Dame, I heard. But we're back from some district baseball, and most of the district games are wrapping up. And I went to the New Madrid game today. They beat Malden in district championship. Freshman dominated the Green Wave, but some surprises with the district baseball. Chaffee went down, and what are your thoughts on the district baseball championships?
I'd say New Madrid a surprise. With what they lost from last year, their state run, and nobody really expected them to maybe even compete for a district title this year, and here they are winning their second in as many years, and to do it with a young group is kind of surprising. But I will say that the competition that they had wasn't as formidable as it was in last year. But they that was another upset last year. Beating Malden the way they did, they crushed Malden the way that they did, and for them to win back to back with a young group, it speaks volumes for their program and Coach McClarty, who's done a great job with them. But that surprised me. Also, obviously Chaffee losing to Bernie 22-10. I don't think anybody expected that ever. Chaffee put on a really good regular season, but you kind of look at their schedule and say, who'd they play? One of those deals. Mm-hmm. And getting to this, it's great to put up 21 seasons, but when you get to this point in the season, you got to be battle tested, so to speak.
Chaffee football, basketball, and baseball all kind of had the same theme. Mm-hmm. They had really good regular seasons and then got to districts and just didn't make it through. And so you kind of feel bad for them. They just never could quite get through. 22-10, that shocks me. Mm-hmm. I never would have thought. But then again, they're playing in Bernie, which is about like a little league field, if I remember right. It's been a while since I've been there, and the wind, I think I heard, was blowing out too. So that's just going to but you've got to
still
you've got to get outs, and you've got to,
you're hitting too.
Yeah. I don't know, but Bernie, they scored like 40 runs in their semifinal championship game, 18 in the semifinal, 22 in the championship, 46 for the tournament in three games. They're hitting the ball well. They're going to go up and play Valley, I believe, and that's going to be a difficult game for Bernie. But you don't have to worry about pitching when you're scoring 20 runs a game. That's impressive.
I mean, you give up 10 runs and you win by 12. That's not, yes, no, not common at all. But Chaffee, the way that this ended, they say goodbye to Cody Payne, who's been one of the better players in the area here. I don't know what's there, but you got to think something just kind of fell with them. I don't know. You don't lose a district championship 22-10. It doesn't really happen a lot.
Yeah, that was kind of surprising. And back to the New Madrid, I was at that game. They completely, I thought, dominated Malden. Palmer Campbell, I believe is his name. He mm-hmm. just shut down the Malden bats. Only allowed three hits. With the exception of one inning where he kind of got a little wild, and that allowed the run to score. Other than that, he was in control from start to finish. They played great defense. A few years ago, New Madrid was not known for their mm-hmm. defense, but they played great defense today. That's really came along, and they look really good. And they play Scott City. Scott City beat them earlier, beginning of the year, when mm-hmm. New Madrid wasn't hitting. New Madrid's really kind of improved their hitting lately. That's a winnable game mm-hmm. for New Madrid. It's not inconceivable that they get all the way to the Final Four again.
And the best thing about this win, obviously the district championship is very good, but they still have Austin Godwin to go in that sectional mm-hmm. to get one more round if they choose to go that way. But like you said, there were no hit the first game against Scott City this mm-hmm. year, and no hit again in that second game. It wasn't a great start for New Madrid to start the season, but to end it with their second straight district championship and have a chance to beat Scott City again, who they beat last year mm-hmm. in the same sectional round. So it should be a pretty good one as far as that goes. I'm not sure where it's played yet.
It'll be at Scott City.
So that should be a pretty good one. And the best thing for them going now, they have Austin Godwin, their number one starter, going with a chance to go even farther now.
Well, if they do get by them, you look in the quarterfinal game, and you're going to have Palmer Campbell, who, if his slider's working like it was today, I mean, he's tough to hit. I mean, right-handers were bailing out all day, just couldn't, were not comfortable at all. And that's when your slider's moving like his was, it's really tough on right-handed batters, which majority of high school players bat right-handed. And so it's it sets up really nice for them. I'm not sure who they would have in the quarterfinal if they get past Scott City. Scott City is another team that, you know, they knocked off Clearwater. They've had a really nice season under Coach May, and you know, they're kind of coming along. I don't think anybody expected them when the season started to win a district title. So that's another team. Both teams are kind of, maybe not where they expected to be at this point in time.
And I think they pitched their number one in Brandon Cox tonight in this district championship. Mm-hmm. So
another freshman.
So exactly. We got a movement of youth here coming. It's kind of exciting, but at the same time, you know, got to get these young guys. These young guys are in a lot of pressure situations here.
Yeah, it's not phasing them though.
No,
I talked to Palmer after the New Matter game, and he said, you know, look, I pitched in a lot of big games before this. You know, I wasn't nervous. You know, this was no big deal, and he pitched like it. Yeah. And I know Brandon Cox is pitched in a bunch of big games too, and summer leagues and things. And so both of them are, definitely making their presence felt, and it's a future's bright for New Madrid and Scott City. This may be a game that's seen for years to come.
Yeah.
So it'll be a fun district or sectional game.
Mm-hmm.
Oran,
yes,
played a barn burner with Advance, mm-hmm. and still they're still district champs, and you got to knock them off to get that crown from them.
This is their district, and this is Orion. They just have just a stranglehold on that district for some, and they seem to always pull it out. No matter the craziest game can go on at Orion, and they just seem to pull it out every mm-hmm. single year. It's just bred in them. They're supposed to win this game. They know it.
And they'll move on to play the winner of the Class One District One, mm-hmm. Which will be played at Risco. Mm-hmm. It's going to be played on Thursday, after the show. So, who knows who they're going to play? But Oran, until somebody beats them, you kind of expect them to keep winning and go all the way to the Final Four.
Defending, they lost a lot of seniors from last year, a lot of prominent seniors from last year, but that team still had that experience of winning a state championship, and they don't want it to end. They want to keep going, get number two.
How many years have we said that? Well, they lost a lot of players, and Oran's
still. It doesn't matter. I think from now on, if we're talking Oran, we should never ever say, "Well, they lost a lot of players." It doesn't matter.
I was thinking about this earlier today. There's a lot of teams that just year in and year out, it doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. They're always up there. The Orans, the Notre Dames, mm-hmm. Kennett lately, the last mm-hmm. Decade or so. It seems like they always have a good team, and we look at teams, we see a lot of teams in the summer. Mm-hmm. A lot of the Little League teams, we hear about this team's going to this World Series and this team's going to that World Series. I know that Sykeston and Dexter both have a big, contingent of mm-hmm. Little League who go on to different, World Series and are always playing in these big tournaments. Yet, the last decade or so, it really hasn't translated into the high school. I mean, it's been, 15, 20 years before Dexter sniffed a district title, and Sykeston has been, coming up, I think 2007 was their last... It was their last district title, if I'm mm-hmm. not mistaken, and they had, there's a few years before there where they, so I mean, do they just not, develop the players, or are they burned out by the time they get to the, that's just something I was just kind of thinking about.
That with the particular programs that you mentioned, Oran and Notre Dame, they stay together. Mm-hmm. those Oran kids, they play from their time in Little League on up to now. I mean, mm-hmm. they're together constantly, and they have good leadership within their programs to kind of build their program up, and the same with Notre Dame. These kids, they are a private school. They kind of come together at the high school level, but they know each other. They've played together. They have kind of you don't want to say it sounds illegal, but they kind of have a feeder kind of system into mm-hmm. their program for all their sports programs, it seems to me, because they come up together. And I know a lot of Sykes and kids, and we are closest experience is Sykes, and we look at that as our tablet, if you will. But I mean, you'll see a team come up, and you'll have this kid come from this town, and this kid, and then they just go to their own high school. Mm-hmm. They don't stay here. I mean, there's a lot of talent that comes up here, but they don't stay together and play together. I, mm-hmm. I don't know. It just doesn't really translate when it gets.
It just seems like there's a lot of games these teams play. Mm-hmm. every weekend we're seeing them play this tournament, that tournament, and I don't know if maybe burnout has something to do with it. By the time they get to high school, maybe they're just kind of tired of playing. And we see how they lose some here and there, and like I said, some go to other schools, mm-hmm. but it's just kind of it's just something I was thinking about earlier today, that the two biggest Little League programs that I've noticed, for teams going to the World Series and this Midwest plan, mm-hmm. in the last 10 years, it'd be Sykeston and Dexter. Other than the Squirrels, who kind of get mm-hmm. get players from everywhere, but they're just the town localized. Sykeston and Dexter, And, you know, they really haven't made much, you know, much noise in baseball when it comes. So, it's just kind of a thing that, one may not have anything to do with the other, but it certainly breeds expectations.
Of course,
and when you get there and then they don't fulfill them, and it's tough on the coaches for one.
No doubt, because like you said, the expectations are there and people expect them to do something with them, mm-hmm. and it's just not there for some. I don't have an answer. I mean, if I did, I might be running a program or something. Yeah. But you're right. I mean, it gets to that point and it just never seems to come to fruition for mm-hmm. teams like Dexter and Sykeson. And I don't know if it's a leadership problem or whatever. I don't really know. But Oran and Notre Dame, won their district again tonight. They beat Kennett very handily. I think it was 12-1 the final. But they're going on again. And Kennett beat Sykeson last night in a very thrilling ending. I don't think the whole game was thrilling, but the ending was very thrilling.
No, the game was not thrilling. I was there. It was. I dozed off a few times. It was. Doug Still's a very good pitcher for Sykeson. Had one bad inning that kind of hurt him. But Kennett's a very good team, a very good program. They threw their ace last night, and he looked really good. But I knew they were going to probably struggle a little bit against Notre Dame. Mm-hmm. But Notre Dame's just. They've got the whole package, and so I expect them to go far in Class 4. And while we're on the subject, and please let's get off the baseball. We're almost done with it.
You got a Cardinal hat. Let's get off the baseball. Bring you wear a hat for the first time. It's Cardinal hat. Let's get off the baseball.
Well, I'm sweating stuff out covering a game. I actually work today, so
that's true. Yeah.
It doesn't happen all the time, but we'll stay with Kennett though. Kennett hired a new assistant football coach in Arlen Pixley, the former head coach at New Madrid, and he's going to be their defensive coordinator. Mm-hmm. I believe the assistant wrestling coach and track coach. Mm-hmm. And janitor. I don't know.
Hey, Pixley's do all. Apparently,
It's going to be the Pixley show down there. His brother Aaron is the head coach, and so I think that's a great hire for Kennett. Kennett is really putting a lot of emphasis on improving their football program, which has been down for many, many, many years. And they're really putting some emphasis on it, and I think it's a great hire.
I talked to both of them today, and they seem very excited to work together again. They worked together at New Madrid for 2 years, I believe, in the early 2000s. And then, obviously, Aaron goes to Dexter and Arlen stays at New Madrid. And they decide to make a change at New Madrid, and he's going to Kennett, that program. And they seem to be very excited to work together. Now, in the past, when they go head-to-head, we the media, try to make a big deal about brother going to mm-hmm. They never really put, bit that apple. But now that they have a chance to work together again, they seem very excited to do that, and it's like coming together. It's good for them, I think, because I think they're going to work well together. Arlen said that they both know strengths and weaknesses, and Arlen is a defensive guy. Mm-hmm. He's a defensive coach, and that's something that Kennett has been lacking,
to say the least. Yeah.
So that'll be good. And the football program, they didn't have a lot of wins last year, but that was a definite improvement. And we knew that there would be with Aaron going down there. And I don't see this as nothing but another positive for that Kennett program.
Yeah, there's a couple things you're going to know. They're going to play aggressively on defense. They're going to be strong. Mm-hmm. They're going to have definitely work on their weight program with both Pixleys there. And but the main thing is they're going to get better. Like you said, they're going to get better in all phases because they're both good coaches. Mm-hmm. And so you got to applaud Kennett for trying to get this thing better down there. It's well overdue. I'm anxious to see Kennett succeed at some football. After several years of I think the last district title was in '86, and they're due.
It's the year I was born.
Yeah. Well, with that, I was like probably junior high. So with that, we're gonna move on.
Larry Bird and Celtics won the championship.
Yeah.
Well, did you watch it on your flip channel, black and white TV?
Yes, I did actually. Oh,
there you go.
So there you go. But before we sign off here, I want to give a congratulations here to Mr. Chris Pobst, who's getting married this weekend. If you see him, wish him happy marriage and all that good stuff that goes along with it. And marrying a very nice lady. And
didn't cost me much at all. Yeah, so I didn't have to pay her a lot.
Not yet, but that's coming. And so if you see him, he's going to be gone next week.
Yes.
So he's going to be on his honeymoon. So we are not going to have a show. But the bloopers that we had back around Christmas went over so well. Our awesome cameraman, Charlie, is going to be putting together another blooper reel for you. So be sure to check that out next week. We have no clue what's going to be on there.
I don't know where he gets his stuff.
I
don't know where he gets it because we don't mess up. I don't see what the big deal is.
We don't think we mess up. He thinks we mess up a lot.
I don't see how he can put a whole show together with perfection.
I wish they could get a camera on him where he's yawning when we're filming the show all
the
time.
Yeah, just chuckling and yawning. And like, 2 minutes.
He's always giving his time. Hurry up. Yeah, shut up. Like he is now. He's sitting there saying, shut up. I want to sign off. So we're going to sign off, and Chris is going to go get married, and I'm going to do his job and mine here at the paper for a week or so.
It's called delegating.
That's right. So we'll be back in 2 weeks. But like I said, be sure to check out the blooper show next week, and we'll see you later.